Sawadikrab, Tukton. My name is Mayank Mishra. I am a System X consultant with Lenovo India. I have been working with Lenovo for 2 years. I have worked with Lenovo, with IBM for the last 7 years earlier. I am working with our architecting, solutioning, designing, and implementation of Lenovo products for various platforms like VMware, Windows, or OpenStack, right? So I'll take small time of your precious time to talk about Lenovo offering with the OpenStack and the cloud solutions. Right, so when we talk about the projection in terms of the future, Lenovo is aggressively working toward the future solutions for the customer, for the users. So as per the Gartner report, when we see that by 2020, we will have approximately 20.8 billion devices connected, which means 5.5 million things or devices will be connected on daily basis. Now those devices could be your smartphone, your automobile cars, your sensors, or various other products which gather the data and analysis as per the requirement. So that is the growth of internet and their benefits. Now, when we talk about the big data advantage here, what we see is that 1/3 of the business in top 20 will be utilizing this OpenStack technology. Now, as per the IDC report, when we see that IDC report, we see that initially, like 90s, 60s, when the companies are a part of S&P 500 list companies, those were the 60-year-old companies. But when we see the current status, the company's average lifetime is approximately 12 years, which means those companies which are formed 12 years back are aggressively moving into S&P 500 list, which is a bigger an advantage for them. So when we talk about those many devices or a big data advantage or heavily future things coming on the way, we need a larger growth, expandability, and flexible environment which cloud can offer. And for a cloud setup, we have OpenStack along with various vendors like VMware, Windows, Azure, Amazon, providing these services. But when we say about cloud, we have two options. We can go for a hybrid cloud when we talk about that a cloud setup could be in your in-premises or in your company's data center, or there's a possibility we can have that data center have their cloud services within the company's name. So when you talk about a hybrid setup and a private cloud setup as a private IT, we have various challenges to set up your cloud, whether it's a hybrid or it's an on-premises IT, right? So one of them, when we see, is that the workload affinity and the risk involved with them. Now, how's that? Whenever we go for a application development or a system development things for a development team or various application users, we see that on a hybrid cloud, we have a less probability to see that. For example, for a private IT, or we say on-premises data center, we can see that we have a less and very high SLA to maintain that. But on a hybrid, that can be easily maintainable. Now, another thing that we can see is your advantages of being an IT growth. Now, when we see about the low and the high risk for the business, there are various things that matters to set up a cloud setup. Example, when we see that for an IT company, like for example, Windows, Microsoft, or a VMware, those companies have a primarily IT business. So the business they run is actually an IT. But for an automobile company, the IT is just an expense for them, very limited amount of expense they put on IT, right? For that, they should go for a hybrid way of solution that they can maintain the lower cost and a high growth from a hybrid solution. But on an in-premises, this could be an option, but this would become as an overcome or a overcost for the customer. Now, for example, when we see about the economics in terms of a cost, so the TCO, which we talk about the total cost of ownership for an IT, in 3 to 5 will be higher than is expected. But for an in-private or a private on-premises cloud setup, this would be fine or as per the requirement. So depending upon the size or the requirement, we can choose an on-premises or private IT cloud environment, or we can go for a hybrid setup, which can be a part of any public cloud company or can be set up in the premises itself. Now, we talk about the on-premises IT have various challenges in the data centers. So one of them is very easy to understand. For example, I'll take a case of any automobile company, and we need a couple of servers for an application development team. Now, when we talk about a team for purchasing a server, it takes a lot of time. For example, you raise a tender with the OEM or with the partner in the market. You have to spec for the sizing of the server. Once we get the various offers and the bids, we choose the right bid and the right partner to work with us. So we order the hardware setup to the partner. Then it takes a couple of weeks to get the hardware in premises. Right, so maybe it takes 2 or 3 weeks of time to get the hardware at the premises. Once it is there, you need a system administrator who can deploy OS applications, various system tools to run for the application team. So this much of a time can take approximately 4 to 6 weeks of a time. So that is an infrastructure challenge to build a system for the customer or a user level thing. So those are the standard challenges for an initial level. Now, when we see it as a certifying and testing, we got the hardware, we install the OS, we install the application, but those are not tested yet. So we put some time for a test setup in my servers, applications, for a development team. Once they approve it, we go for a production setup. Right? So this much of a time is required just to get an infrastructure ready for a user or an application level. Apart from that, when you go for a software thing, we need some more time on that because various users have various requirement, policies, security concerns. So those are the customization things which come up with the user requirement or a development team requirement or for any matter of any services. Apart from that, once setup is there and we are able to utilize that setup, we need somebody to be part of the operation team to do the maintenance job, right? To do the upgrades for any server or for any application that we are going to utilize. For example, we have a Windows 2012 OS. After 6 months or after 3 months of time, Microsoft has releases some patch, some fix. So we want to have upgrade of those patches and fixes. So it is a maintenance job to do the update on daily basis, probably every quarter or every 3 to 4 months of time. So that's a maintenance job that comes with our infrastructure things. Now, when you talk about forecasting or estimation of things, It is not easy to estimate at initial standard infrastructure. For example, we have 10 servers and hundreds of VM machines running on the systems, and we are utilizing that. But suddenly, there's one more project came up, and customer need maybe 50 or 60 VM more in a week of time, right? So that is not immediately possible for any standard user to have those things ready, because he has to go through finance, various policies, and administration tasks to at least get those things running and ready for the new project, right? So even he cannot utilize the existing one if there is a out of a policy thing. So compliance is also a concern for a new infrastructure here. Change, rapid growth. I am talking about a scenario we need lots of dynamic things required for various users. For example, we have a software company which develops the application for a mobile user. Now, those application needs update for a security level, and we need application for new features. So those are the changes. But the development team cannot simply go and deploy those latest fixes and change the code right away on a production setup. It needs a POC setup. It needs some test environment to do the testing first, then go for an actual deployment on a project of a production system. So those changes will not be easily available with a traditional IT infrastructure. Now, so at initial level of infrastructure problems, there are various challenges that we discuss now. But when we see more, so at the end of the day, there are few points that will be a part of a challenges for any customer. The first one would be skill and expertise to deploy at a cloud setup or maybe your in-house IT infrastructure. The second is integration. Oh, when you talk about integration, which means that you want to utilize an existing infrastructure or existing server setup to be part of a new private or a hybrid cloud setup. So it is not easy for anybody, for a customer point of view, to integrate those setup in the existing setup. Now, there are various things that we can choose that from a VMware point of view, or Azure, or Amazon, or any other public cloud vendor. But that always comes with a lock-in mechanism, right? So when we are using Amazon things, Amazon resources and the services, those services will keep on remaining with Amazon as long as they want, and we have to stuck with their policies, with their finance mechanism, or their with the cost. Availability and reliability. So availability and is always fine with the hybrid or any other company, but it is still a challenge for a new startup company to work at a cloud level. Now, when we talk about Lenovo, being a Lenovo solution-based company, we provide various things for a customer to utilizes their existing resources to make it easy to integrate with the existing resources, optimize it well, predict well with the customer. Now, it also provides us the end-to-end assistance. So when we do a sizing, for example, a customer wants to have analysis of their system. So from a Lenovo expertise, we do a consulting and provide the analysis report of the existing setup and come up with a solution which can be helpful for them to go on the road of OpenStack or a cloud form. So there are various points that we can prove that Lenovo is integrated and a solid performer for innovation. So we have 6 world record for Intel Spec 2003 benchmarking for highly performance workload for a virtualized infrastructure. The second is for performance per watt, which means in a server when we run VM machines and the various VM machine run on a particular server, the cost of energy efficiency is the highest with the Lenovo than any other vendor or the OEM in the market. So I am talking about X3650 model. With Lenovo, we have two innovation centers that work with the customer to ensure the right journey from a traditional architecture to the cloud path. So one we have is in Beijing and China, which will be providing the consultancy and support for any existing customer which he want to initiate the journey toward a OpenStack or the cloud services, where we provide a POC setup. For example, a customer want to have the real-time example of those services and requirement. So that kind of a setup can be deployed at Lenovo Innovation Center to see how much workload and how much data or how much resources are required to simulate that exact same thing on my new cloud setup. Second is your existing system technology innovation center. Now that will be utilizing for a deployment of a traditional architecture. For any customer who want to utilize and do a test setup or do a hybrid solution workload, that can be tested with the Lenovo support team who will be partnering with the customer and providing the value addition to the customer. Now, for a Lenovo point of view, what we intended to be is world number one infrastructure solution based company, where, right, so we have the right value, right product, right solution and consulting to help the customer to achieve their business needs and requirements. Now we are partnering with various OEMs and open source company like Red Hat, Mirantis, or Redfish companies, just to be a part of an industry where our hardware, our product, our solution can be deployed with the open source community. Now, we have various companies who are part of this open source, right? And for an open source thing, one of them is Open vSwitch, VLAN, Chef Storage, and Hybrid Data Management. So engineering and development of those open source codes and development is very much handled by Lenovo to contribute and to grow the open source community. We are corporate sponsors of open source community to making it more growing and a benefit open source standard. Now, so we have been a great partner with Red Hat, which is a world leader for open source. If you see the journey for the Red Hat, they have started in 1993, and since then they have come across a long way to grow the open source community and their products in the world. So Red Hat has been a part of a projects and various companies of Fortune 500 and running critical solutions, running critical applications for them, and supporting them by 24/7 or 365 days. So that's actually an enterprise company providing various solutions and running a critical enterprise businesses. Now, Lenovo and Red Hat has a partnership to do more onto this open source community. Because being a Lenovo product-based company, Lenovo has various products like mobile, desktop, servers, networking, storage. So these infrastructures are actually a part of an enterprise company where we need these things on a regular basis. So from a Red Hat point of view, they have various tools, virtualization environment, OpenStack products and solution, which are part of a security and networking or other various requirement for the customer. So when we talk about the Lenovo and Red Hat being together, we have a lot more to gain. For example, when we go with a Red Hat OpenStack thing, Lenovo will be the end-to-end support mechanism, deployment, sizing for customer. So being a Lenovo customer, we have end-to-end solution. So initially, we can analyze the existing environment. Sizing can be done as per the customer requirement for the future growth or the utilizing the existing infrastructure. Once it is settled down, we can provide the various product for the customer. Once product is there, it is our job to ensure that those product or those solution which we provide to the customer should be deployed or implemented as per the customer requirement. So once it is deployed, we ensure that it is running at an operational value to our customer. So it's a great partnership for Lenovo and Red Hat to gain more business for the customers. Right, so as my fellow speakers earlier mentioned about OpenStack various components, I'll take small amount of time just to go through an overview of these things. And just to add one more thing, we have a few gifts for the audience who will be distributed among you. Right, so Lenovo and Red Hat has a partnership and providing end-to-end OpenStack cloud solution. So at a startup level, we have Lenovo X-Clarity hardware management tool, which is actually an appliance which can be utilized for deployment of a bare metal OS, monitoring of the system at a hardware layer. It is an agentless appliance and a management software, which will be part of a support mechanism as well. Now, on top of the Lenovo hardware or the servers, we have Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7.2 or the other versions, which will be installed on Lenovo servers. Once that is done, we have few components that comprise to make an OpenStack solution. One of them is a compute. So compute object is actually the object which runs the computation power for the users. So whenever user asks to deploy some code, we have a computation resources available to run those codes. Then we have image services. those image services component where we are going to utilize to deploy the OS. For example, we need a VM, maybe two VMs of Linux or Windows machine or a SUSE. So we can keep the ISO images into my image service component. So whenever there is a requirement of a new VM, the OpenStack solution should get the ISO image from the image service and deploy it right away. Then there is the object storage. So object storage is going to help you with the requirement where we need some file level things. For example, now we use FTP for Windows. So those requirements or a file level will be taken care by object storage. Network. For a network, we have a Neutron component from an OpenStack portfolio. The Neutron component will be doing the network communication traffic along with the various components. Last, Lenovo service, identity service. So those are the part of your OpenStack. The last thing is that we need a dashboard or a heat where user can ask for a new VMs and their requirement. And then last, we have a Red Hat Cloud Form. So Red Hat Cloud Form will be a single management appliance where it can be utilized for a private in-house data center cloud solution or a hybrid one. So with Red Hat Cloud Form, you can integrate your Amazon VMware or Azure cloud solution with the existing OpenStack solutions. As we do not have much time, I may have to rush a bit. Apologize for that. With Lenovo and Red Hat, we have a reference architecture which talks about designing things, taking references for how do we configure OpenStack solution from Red Hat on top of a hardware from Lenovo. So just for a small overview, we have these 3650M5 servers, which is actually a 2U server. We have 10G network switches on top of that. So these 10G will be going to utilize under data communication or your various ISO communication. Once it is there, we have XClarity, a part of a management thing for the servers. So that will be you going to utilize for a health monitoring of the hardware and their log analysis at a hardware level. Or if there any problem with the hardware, XClarity will call home the support services at Lenovo for a proactive solutions. So this is for a cloud form solution where we are talking about in-house premises using Red Hat reference architecture and various hybrid solutions available. So if you have Amazon, VMware, Red Hat existing, or Microsoft, you can utilize those existing running cloud services and integrate with the cloud form to make a single management for you. So that is an OpenStack component as a cloud form proposed by Red Hat. Earlier, it was hard for a customer or for anybody to go with the OpenStack because of its bit complexity. But with Red Hat and Lenovo partnership, it is easy to go from a zero to a full-fledged, ready OpenStack cloud solution. It is easy to deploy, install the hardware, deploy the Red Hat OSP director, get the new nodes part of the director, assign various roles like compute, network, storage, controller. Verify the deployment with minimal user intervention or a manual intervention, and finalize the operation cloud. So this partnership has bring the OpenStack cloud very easy and accessible to integrate and deploy for the customer. From a Lenovo point of view, we ensure the customer get maximum benefit or maximum utilization of their resources and their money. Lenovo has enterprise solution team and a professional team which do the assessment of an existing workload, design the solution for the customer as per the requirement, see the sizing for the future growth. Deployment is a part of a professional services team. If customer agrees, we will deploy everything as per the customer requirement, fulfill their requirement, deploy and operations. Once it is deployed, we ensure customer has the capabilities or the knowledge to run the OpenStack cloud solution which we deployed. So training is a part of an enterprise professional services team. Enablement, and once it is deployed and handed over to the customer, we also support the customer for their deployment setup. Just for reference, recently Lenovo India has deployed cloud form solution with one of the largest airline company in India using Nutanix as a infrastructure and appliance solution along with cloud form. So right now everything is on the Nutanix for a storage, for a network, for a cloud and computation. Then the management is done by the cloud form from Red Hat. So this is one of the use case for a deployment. So the engagement with Lenovo is all about end-to-end solution. From a sizing perspective, for implementation, for deployment, operational point of view, or a maintenance, we ensure end-to-end solution to the customer. Our goal is to ensure we will be number one data center partner for a customer in various segments, from a compute perspective, network, storage, cloud platforms, or operational point of view, and support. So we ensure that we should be able to help the customer as much as possible to be a data center partner at a number one position in the world. Our technology and growth is always growing. Thank you. Khop khun krab.